I will explain you what you need to do to make your photos look like Blvck Paris. For those who don't know Blvck Paris, you can check their Instagram account by clicking the link below. This channel shares black colored photos and emphasizes the yellow tone in the photos. I will try to achieve this look by making some edits on a few photos. I will make these edits using Lightroom on desktop, but the general logic is the same in photo editing programs. Let me remind you that you can achieve the same result by making similar edits in mobile Lightroom. I have selected some images for you and we are going to edit them. We will make this edit on one of them and apply the same settings to the others. In order to edit photos in Lightroom, we need to go to the Develop tab at the top, and we will try to get the black effect with the edits we will make here. Of course, the values here will not be similar in all photos. Since the brightness of your photo is not the same as the brightness of my photo, you need to make the edits here accordingly. Therefore, we may need to do this roughly and come here last. The thing we need to know here are that white should be on the far left and we need to open a black a little bit so that we reduce the contrast value a little bit more. But as I said, it is good to look at the values here last. We also need to make some adjustments to the saturation value of the photo. We need to make some adjustments to the colors. So, we will need to adjust the clarity option here, as well as the vibrance and saturation values. We can make the clarity value plus 25. We can leave the vibrance value and saturation value at minus 25 or minus 30. When we examine the photo, we can see that the saturation has decreased and the colors have decreased. It started to turn into a photo with a style. Now, let's close the basic field here. The place we are going to edit right now is tone curve. Make sure that the RGB option is selected here. And let's click on roughly a quarter of the line here from the top and the bottom. I'm clicking on the top. There is a dot here. And I'm clicking on the bottom one. And I'm shifting the values here down a little bit. And I've also shifted the value here down a little bit. And when we turn this effect off, we have got an effect from here to here. And we have balanced the highlights and the shadows in the photo a little bit more. We can close the tone curve panel. Now, we are at the point where we can really enhance the photo. I am selecting the saturation tab here. What was our goal? We wanted to emphasize the red and the orange. And sometimes we need to emphasize the yellow. Starting from the bottom, let's move all the colors here to the far left so that they are in black and white. Just leave the red and orange colors here. We can give them values of plus 20 or plus 10, depending on the photo. Let's switch to the luminance tab from the tabs at the top and give the red and orange values here minus 10. According to this photo and by switching to the hue tab, let's give the orange slider here a value of minus 10. Thus, we will get a slightly more red-oriented photo. The photo looks black and white here. We will need to bring it a little bit closer to blue tones to make it look like the photos on the black Instagram account. For that, we close the tab here and activate the split tonic panel. I make the first value here 210. I make the following value 220. You will not see any editing right now because we will need to select the sliders at the bottom. This time I make the saturation 5 and I make the saturation below 10. And as you can see, there is a bluing in the photo. It is gone from those passive gray tones to a bluing. It was like this. This is what we have managed to achieve with the adjustments we have just made. These are actually the settings. These are the basic settings that we need to give this black effect. Now let's come back to the top and look at the adjustments here. It looks good even as it is. Let's increase the contrast value a little bit to make the photo more beautiful. And if you want, we can also increase the exposure value here a little bit. I think these settings are good enough. I'm moving on to the library section, and in the library section here, I apply the same effect to other photos. So, I transfer the edits we have made here to them. We can also do this as a shortcut. We can do it with Ctrl+Alt+V. When you press these buttons, that is when you press these buttons on another photo, this is what it does. It means take the effects from the last selected photo and transfer them to the new photo. We can do the same thing with the others. And we can even do it in batches, not individually. For example, right now, I have this photo selected and I have some edits on this photo. I click on this one and then shift click on the last one and all the photos in between are selected. I could have selected them individually with the Ctrl key if I wanted to. Now I'm using the same key combination again. I press Ctrl+Alt+V. It transfers the effects from the last photo to the other selected photos. At the bottom there is a beaming mode. This is the fourth one from the left. I will select all the photos and then I will click on this. It is a nice presentation format. This mode already has survey mode on it, which is a mode that allows you to select the photos. But sometimes I also display these photos in this way because it looks nice. The first photo, the car photo, is not compatible with the others because it is a horizontal photo. So let's make the car photo compatible with the others. Let's make it a vertical photo. I go to develop, I press the letter R on the keyboard and it activates the crop mode. And I go to the original option on the right panel. I'm selecting this one. I know the other photos are in this format. When I have selected this one, I'm making it so that it is vertical. And then I'm placing it and then I'm pressing enter. It should probably be in the same proportion as the others. Now I select all of them and then I go back to survey mode. And as you can see, this is where I can view all the photos at once. And if you look at each photos individually, it works very well. And you can save this effect as a preset and use it later without having to adjust these settings again. When we open the left panel in the develop section, I click on the arrow next to the preset option and I give it a name by clicking create preset and I save it in the user presets section. The user presets group is here, so it will be saved under this. I click on the create button and as you can see, the name we just gave is here. So when I add a photo from scratch here, we can make this photo ready by clicking on the black section, clicking on the black preset and then making basic edits on it. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope it was useful. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.